Hello, Catherine. How are you?
Hey, Dr. Marshlinsky. I'm well. How are you?
Excellent. Excellent. Thank you. I'd love to hear more about the training session that you just attended related to the biophysics of PFA.
Absolutely. It was very insightful.
Now, it sounded very exciting. So tell me more. Walk me through it and share your thoughts on the big takeaway messages you left with.
Sure. Well, first up was Dr. Verma, who had a great presentation on electroporation. The graphics and concepts that he shared were pretty straightforward, but the way that he presented it made it approachable and real.
To begin to understand pulse field ablation, we first need to understand what electroporation is. Electroporation is really the application of an electrical field across a tissue. That electrical field goes between positive and negative poles, and as it passes through the tissue, it creates a number of cellular changes. In particular, what happens to cardiac cells is that as the electrical field goes through, pores open up in the cell membranes. Once those pores open up, that creates cellular disruption and changes in cellular function, which then leads to a cascade of events which end in programmed cell death, otherwise known as apoptosis. Now, the effects that an electrical field will have on the cell depends both on the magnitude of the field as well as the duration over which that field is applied. If we apply a very small field over a very short period of time, there will be no effect on the cellular function. However, if we start to increase the magnitude of the field as well as the duration of the field, we can get what is called reversible electroporation, where the membrane pores form. However, they rapidly reseal so that cellular integrity and cellular function is maintained. On the other hand, if we start to further increase the magnitude of the field and the duration over which it's applied, we start to get irreversible electroporation, and that's really what we want for ablation. Because here, the cellular pores will open, they will stay open, and then eventually the cells will end up with programmed cell death. However, if we start to turn up the field too much and deliver it over too long a period of time, then we're going to start to get thermal effects, in which case PFA would be no different than radiofrequency or cryoablation. In terms of the time course over which these changes happen, the actual delivery of the electroporation energy may only take several nanoseconds or microseconds, so it's very, very fast. However, the disruptions in the cell membrane and the formation of pores in the cell membrane can take anywhere from seconds to minutes. And then eventually, the steps that lead to irreversible cell death or apoptosis may take anywhere from minutes to days. In fact, there is some data suggesting that it can take 7 to 10 days for an electroporated lesion to fully mature in cardiac cells.
So basically, electroporation is high energy electrical pulses over time. They disrupt the cell membrane, kill the cell, and destroy the arrhythmia sources or pathways, being cautious to avoid any structures beyond the cardiac tissue, of course.
Very good, Catherine. Well said. I'd love to hear more about the other presentations.